Hey guys, welcome you all. You are in data section and algorithm series. So today we are going to see binary search. Let's get started. First of all, what is binary search? Finally, binary search is also known as half interval search, logarithmic search, and binary job. It mostly preferred for to find a question of target value within a sorted array. So how it works? In generally, binary search is having three parts. First, we need to find the middle element. Then we need to compare it. That middle element is equal to the target element. It is equal, then return the index. If not, we need to find the, we need to go the second step. The second step is we need to find the lesser, that target value is lesser or greater. If it is lesser, we need to eliminate all the greater values. If it is greater, then we should eliminate all the lesser values. Then we should do the same process again and again. So mostly this process is eliminating n by 2 elements in each iteration, and it's a recursive process. So we need to know what is recursion. So if you are not aware of recursion, don't forget to watch our previous videos, especially in the problem solving techniques. So in that video, we clearly explain about that. Move forward. So this is an example of binary search. So in this example, so we having one sorted array. So don't forget, binary search is used for sorted array. So we have a sorted array. In this array, we need to find 23. So in this array, if 23 is present, it should return that index. If it is not present, then it should return minus 1. So let's see how binary search will work in this problem. So the thing is, initially we should find middle value. So how to find middle value is, so the total length is 10. 10 divided by 2 will be 5. So it should be in the fourth index. So m is equal to 4. The value is 16. So then we should compare with our target value. The first thing is, if the middle value is equal to 23, no, it's not. So we need to move forward. Then we have two conditions. The first one is the middle value is greater or lesser. So 16 is lesser than 23. So we should eliminate all the lesser values, including 16. So we have rest of the array. So in this example, we have 23, 38, 56, and 72, 91. So we have this array, and we need to do the same thing again. Again, we need to find middle value. Of these 5 elements, the middle value is 56. Now we need to find the condition. What is the condition? The middle value is equal to search element? No, it's not. Then 23 is lesser 56? Yes, exactly. So we should eliminate all the greater values, including 56. So we eliminate all those things. So now we have only 2 elements. So 2 by 2 is equal to 1. So now our middle value is 23. So what we need to do? Our target value and middle value. So 23 is equal to 23. Yes. So we finally found that element, and we should return the index. What is the index? 5. So this is the way binary search works. Don't forget, I just repeating thing. Initially we need to find middle value. Then we should compare our middle value to target value. It is equal, then our job done. Just return the index of the value. If not, then we need to compare with value whether that middle value is lesser or greater. If it is lesser, eliminate all the greater values. If it is greater, then eliminate all the lesser values. Repeat the same thing until we find the exact position of the target value. That is. So to solve this problem, the worst case of time complexity is O log n. because in each iteration, in each recursion, it eliminates n by 2 values. So in this example, we have totally 10 elements. So in the first recursion, it eliminates 5 elements. In the second element, in the second recursion, it eliminates 3 elements. And finally, it eliminates 1 element. So in each iteration, it eliminates n by 2 elements. So that is called itself. It also known as logarithmic way as well. This time complexity is log n. That's all, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for immediate notification. Bye bye.